All right, before we start dinner, we're going to have some speeches. And we have some guests that are...
Shimal and I actually went to high school together. So there was a point in time in our lives when we were younger that we knew each other. And that ultimately led him and Kayla to meeting one fateful night at Shiraz, which ultimately has led all of us here today. So you're welcome. She's not only breathtakingly gorgeous, but she's also one of the most generous and kind people I've ever met in my life. Kayla, I speak for our entire family when I say that you're beyond proud and amazed at the woman you've become. And this personal compliments her, for he is also just as kind-hearted and caring and generous. These are two people that will drop anything at a moment's notice to be with family, to help family, to do anything for the ones they love because we are so special to them, just as they're so special to us. But I have a couple things I'd like to get from you guys. So the first is something that was told to my husband and I from a priest at a wedding we attended. And this priest knew a lot of just like Jesus. I kid you not. Like he was living, breathing Jesus on earth. But what he said is stick with me for the rest of my life. He said the most important part of marriage is forgiveness. Forgive yourselves, forgive each other, always forgive. For we are human. And then the second part of advice that I want to give you came from the matriarch of our family, a woman that Kayla knew most of her life and Shimal had the pleasure of getting to know. And since Grandma's not here with us physically today, I'll share with you what she told me. She said, just love each other. It's that simple. Because in the end, nothing else matters. So if you would please raise your glasses.
Your pronunciation today in America is amazing.
Wow, that's going to be a tough act to follow. Thank you, Michelle. Those are very kind words. I don't have a prepared speech. It's all going to be from the heart, and I'm trying to make it short. Shimal, I'm so proud of you. And you all should be very proud of Shimal. You've raised a fine son. He does so much to help with us around the house. He's a good man. He's got a kind heart. He stays active. He's engaged. And I really appreciate that. You get it from the bottom of my heart. And I know that. And I accept that. And I acknowledge it. And I own it. But I'm very, very proud of you and how you turned out. You're a beautiful, wonderful, smart, intelligent woman. I wanted just to say a few things about faith over love. Your house should be built with faith over love. Most important to me is love. Your foundation should be love. If you don't have love, you don't have anything else. Love, communication. I'm very proud of you both. I love you both very much. I wish you nothing but the best. I can't wait to see you as you grow, and I hope that you add to our families. And I can't wait to see the results of that. All that handsome and gorgeous family. I love you both.
How are you? Good. All right. So I'm going to be thinking to yourself, what the hell is Shimal with this crazy white boy? Shimal is everything you can ask for when it comes to being a friend, son, and husband. His love, passion, and drive to be a great friend, son, and husband is truly inspiring. I cannot be more happy for Kayla and Shimal. I love you both, and thank you for having me on this special guest.
Shimal, not because he's my son, but I know for a fact, and I'm sure everybody would agree with me, that he has got such a big heart, and he would do anything and everything for everyone.
Oh, Here. Kayla,
let's see. I'm here. Come in, Shimal. 28. 28.